Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. In today's video, I'll talk about two of my favorite bags, the Sunref Mini Luna and the Sunref Aria Belt Bag. If you want to know how I style them and the pros and cons of the bags, please keep on watching. Just a little disclaimer, this video is not sponsored. I am a Sunref ambassador and I do have a promo code for you. Apply my code SILLYBILLY for $50 off. I can earn a small percentage of commission when my viewers use my code. I recently did an unboxing video on the Sunref Aluna bag. Make sure you check out that video if you'd like to know my first impressions and have a look at the Sunref pop-up store in Hong Kong. I have also done an in-depth review on the Aluna and the Mini Aluna bag, and in that video I talked about the differences between those two bags and what fits in the bags. The Aria Belt bag was the first bag I purchased from Sunref. It was before I became their ambassador. In fact, my first ever YouTube video is a review on the Aria Belt bag, and I'll link that video in the description box. I have owned the Aria Belt bag for almost 8 months and it's still one of my favorite mini bags. I love it so much that I have bought it in 3 different colors, and in my Sunref collection video, you'll see how I style them with different outfits. So now let's talk about some basic information of the Mini Aluna bag and the Aria Belt bag, such as the dimensions and the price. The Mini Aluna bag that I got is in the color Scarlet. It retails for $575. I'll put the dimensions and the weight of the bag on the screen. Considering that it's made of leather, it's pretty lightweight, and it's actually about the same weight as the Aria Belt bag. I would say these two bags are about the same size and they fit pretty much the same amount of things, but the Mini Aluna bag is closer to a square shape, but the Aria Belt bag is closer to a rectangular shape. The Aria Belt bag that I have right here is in the color chestnut. The price starts at $445, but the price varies with different leather texture and color. And I've got this in the pebbled leather, so it's at $445. But if you get it in dragon leather or like a mix suede and leather texture, then it might be a bit more expensive. And as I said, it's pretty much the same weight as the Mini Aluna bag, and they are both really lightweight bags. They both have an adjustable and detachable strap, but the Aria Belt bag has a longer strap because you can wrap the strap around your waist and wear it as a belt bag. But the Aluna bag, you can wear it as a backpack and the straps are a little bit shorter. The Aria has belt loops on the back so you can attach your straps, but the Mini Aluna bag does not have belt loops, it does have D-rings. The Aria comes in a great variety of colors, including pastel colors and seasonal colors, and also different leather textures such as dragon leather and mimosa leather. Therefore, the price varies depending on different leather texture. And the Mini Aluna is available in one leather type and around 7 colors currently. Apart from the shape of the bag, I would say the main difference between these two bags is that the Mini Aluna bag has a top handle, but the Aria Belt bag does not, so you can use the Aria Belt bag as a clutch, but the Mini Aluna bag can be used as a handheld bag. They are both made of premium quality Italian leather, and the leather is scratch resistant, stain resistant, and water resistant. As you can see, I'm scratching the bag with my nails and nothing really happened to the bags, so it's really scratch resistant. And I also tried to pour some water on the bags, and you can see it's water resistant and the things inside the bag will not get soaked. I love how durable the leather is, so I don't have to baby the bag and I can wear it even when it's raining outside. And when you get some water on it, you can just wipe it with some tissues and gently dab it and dry it. I'm very impressed by the quality of their bags, and this is one of the main reasons why I love Sanraf so much, and they can be really great travel bags. They both feature a flap closure with a magnetic snap button, and this is kind of like a signature look of the Sanraf bags because the Maestro bag also has this kind of closure, and the bags that I have are in a gold hardware. When you open the bags, you can see they both have a really soft and stain-resistant micro suede interior. I really like the micro suede material because when you put your keys in it, it won't scratch the bag. And you can also put your glasses in the bag and the bag will not scratch your glasses. Another main difference is that the Mini Luna has an elongated zipper with a magnetic zipper hold, so it's more secure and the zipper will not move around. But for the Aria belt bag, it does not have a zip closure, it only has a magnetic closure. So now let me show you how I style these two bags. I think they both have style and practicality. The Aria belt bag can be worn as a belt bag, a sling bag, a crossbody, or a clutch. You can also switch the leather strap to a chain strap, and it can be a really cute evening bag for formal events. I would say my favorite way to wear this bag is to wear it as a crossbody bag with a gold chain because I think it looks really good with gold hardware. And when I use it as a travel bag, I like to wear it as a belt bag because I can keep my hands free, and I think a belt bag is really trendy and fashionable. And for the Mini Luna bag, because the straps are adjustable and detachable, you can wear it as a backpack and a shoulder bag or a crossbody bag. You can also use it as a top handle bag, which is really cute. My favorite way to style the Luna bag is to wear it as a backpack, especially when I'm using it as a day bag and I put most of my daily essentials in it. I like to wear it as a backpack so I can distribute the weight evenly on my shoulders. You can also get a Sanraf statement strap to go with the Mini Luna bag. I feel like this kind of guitar straps are really trendy right now. A lot of designer brands have this kind of guitar straps, and it can instantly elevate the look and transform the bag. It can go really well with casual outfits, and it's also very comfortable. The statement strap is currently available in 3 colors. I hope Sanraf will make this strap in more colors and more patterns so we can mix and match the straps for our different Sanraf bags. The Aria belt bag and the Mini Luna bag are both really classic and understated. I like how it only has a small logo instead of some really extravagant slogans. They are both really versatile and multifunctional. Now I'm gonna talk about the compartments of the bags and what fits inside. As you can see, the Aria belt bag has an exterior pocket. You can put some cards in it. It also has some card slots and a zip pocket. The main compartment can fit up to an iPhone 8 Plus. I like how the Aria belt bag has some card slots in it, so sometimes I don't even use a card holder or a wallet. And for the Mini Luna bag, it has one exterior pocket, two internal pockets, and a pen holder, but it does not have a zip pocket. You can put your makeup items and your AirPods in the pockets so you can keep the things more organized. Let me show you what fits in the Aria belt bag. As you can see, it can fit most of my daily essentials, but it can't really fit an umbrella or a water bottle. It can fit my glasses, a card holder, my iPhone 8 Plus, a compact wallet from Charles & Keith, some makeup items. It can also fit my AirPods, and if you're using it as a travel bag, you can also put your sunglasses in it. And now let's see if we can fit all of these items in the Mini Luna bag. As the Mini Luna bag has small compartments, you can keep your things more organized. It fits around the same amount of things that you can fit in the Aria belt bag. It can fit my iPhone 8 Plus, my AirPods, a card holder, my Charles & Keith wallet, my glasses, and some makeup items. Now let me talk about some pros and cons of each bag. As you can see, the Mini Luna bag has slightly thinner straps. I feel like the straps of the Mini Luna bag are slightly softer and therefore more comfortable when you're wearing it as a crossbody bag. And it also has a shoulder pad, so the strap will not dig into your shoulder. I personally prefer thinner straps, and I think they look better when you're carrying the bag, so I would say this is a pro for the Luna bag. Another reason why I prefer the Mini Luna bag over the RA belt bag is because I personally prefer backpacks over belt bags, especially really cute small backpacks. When it comes to removing and adjusting the straps, I would say it works easier for the RA belt bag because it works just like a belt that you use for your trousers. And for the Mini Luna bag, when you have to remove the straps, you have to do it on both sides and it kind of takes more time. Also, when the bag is new, the leather is kind of stiff, so it takes some time to remove the straps, but as you use it more often, it becomes easier to detach the straps. And another pro for the RA belt bag is that it's a bit more affordable because the RA belt bag starts at $445, but the Mini Luna retails for $575. But of course, if you're getting the RA belt bag in dragon leather or mimosa leather, it might be a bit more expensive. When it comes to the versatility of the bag, I would say the RA belt bag is a bit more versatile because you can wear it as a clutch and you can add a chain strap for it when you want to use it for formal events. You can also use it as a travel bag, but I would say the Mini Luna is pretty casual. So if you want to get one bag that is really multifunctional and you can use it in different events and different situations, I would say the RA belt bag is a good choice. So this video is a pretty long video. In conclusion, I love both bags and I use them for different purposes. I can't really say which one is better because they each have their pros and cons, and after all, it all comes down to personal preferences and needs. I highly recommend these two Sunref bags. They're really versatile and great quality. I hope you find this video useful. And if you have any questions about the bags, you can leave a comment and I would love to tell you more about it. If you're considering to purchase it, you can use my code SILLYBILLY for $50 off. Thanks for watching as always. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!